Hi guys, I'm Leo from Leonerd, welcome back, and in today's video I'll teach you some tips and tricks about making the most out of the camera you already have. Technology is getting better and better, and cameras are following that rhythm too. And in filmmaking and photography, there's this misconception where you can't shoot a nice photo or video with a not so good camera. This more expensive stuff for filmmaking and photography do make a difference. They are made to make your life easier, the editing process faster, but that doesn't mean you can't shoot great quality videos or photos with a not so good camera. You can do that with an entry-level camera or even with your phone. And yeah, we are going to discuss that today, and I'll give you some tips and tricks on how to avoid this misconception and get great results with the camera you already own. So, why lighting? It's because these entry-level cameras and phone cameras usually aren't that great for light. So right here in the situation, I got controlled lighting. I have a light here, and a light behind me as well. And I have the controlled lights, and an entry-level camera would look pretty good in this situation too. So it's very important to have great lighting. Another nice tip is shoot in sunlight, sunsets. They will look just fine because you aren't pushing your camera to its limits. The second important thing is framing. And framing is actually inside composition. And what is composition? Composition are the elements that involve your photo or your video. You can have a background, you can have a foreground, a midground, a subject. The subject can be a person, can be a bear, can be a palm tree, can be really anything that you want to use on your story. Now that we know what is composition, what is framing? Framing is basically the way you're gonna freeze your composition in a still image or in a sequence. The way, I mean, the angle, the height, more to this side or more to this side. Let's say I have two palm trees and a person right here. Will I take a photo with only this palm tree, or only this palm tree, or only of the person, or both palm trees? I have infinity options. So you gotta play with that. You gotta check your surroundings and change your angles, change your positions, your perspectives. And that is what is going to make your cell phone photography, your entry-level camera photography, your action cam photography much better. You gotta keep those things in mind, and every time you're on the field shooting, you gotta have that on your head and know what you're doing. Oh, I didn't like this angle, so try another one. You gotta keep trying until you improve it. So guys, this video will end here. I hope you enjoyed. If you did, please leave it a like and subscribe if you haven't already. Also, turn on post notifications so you don't miss out whenever I post new videos. As I always say in my videos, you have to grab your camera and try. So if you have a cell phone camera, some have pro modes which you can maneuver aperture, ISO, shutter speed, some don't. So you gotta know how your cell phone works or your camera and get the most out of it. You gotta try as well as knowing the theory which I taught you. So keep that in mind and go create. And as always, I'll see you soon. Bye bye.